Gadisar Lake was the only source of water for Jaisalmer city. It's a man-made reservoir constructed by King Jaisal. And today I will say it's a wonderful place to pass your time in evening, enjoy a boat ride, or just sit at the ghats and observe magnificent sunset. Now we are at Patwon ki Haveli. It's a very interesting piece of architecture and is the most important among Havelis in Jaisalmer. It's a cluster of 5 Havelis, one of which is now open for public and rest are under control of government. It was constructed in year 1805 by Guman Chandra Patwa, who was the rich trader, and he built it for his 5 sons. And finally, we are at Desert Festival. Many people don't know about the history of this festival, so here is the brief of it. Legend says that Lord Krishna, the ruler of Yadav community, told Arjun once that a successor belonging from the Yadav community will set up his kingdom on the Trikuta hill. In year 1196, the prediction made by Lord Krishna came true when Rawal Jaisal, descendant of Yadav clan, established his kingdom in Jaisalmer. And today, for that prediction, every year in the Hindu month of Magh, which comes in Feb, this desert festival is celebrated. Lot of things they do here, like camel stunt, turban tying competition, Mr. and Miss Desert competition, statue competition. It's basically a 3-day festival.
Well, good morning guys, I hope you guys are doing good. It's a pretty sunny day here in Jaisalmer. Oh, of course, we are still at Jaisalmer. I guess in this trip, we have changed our program on hourly basis, I guess. And yesterday we have to go to sand dunes, but we didn't went there because we did not get the bookings. But we got a link, and today the sand dunes tents are booked, and we also tried for this to go to border. For that we need a permission from collectorate office, but unfortunately or maybe fortunately, all the government officers are busy in this desert festival, Jaisalmer festival, so no permission for us right now to go to border area. But for sure we are going to sand dunes, and hopefully we will be visiting few villages also. And one village which I want to go is the haunted village. What's the name of that village?
Kuldhara.
And Saurabh is quite busy in eating his breakfast. What you are eating? Again poha?
Poha.
Yes, poha, poha, poha. And he also served me.
Yeah.
Poha. I guess in eight or nine days he had eaten poha like 18 times or maybe 20 times. His breakfast, his lunch, and sometimes even dinner. He is a poha man. I guess the people of MP are so much happy that they had invented this dish especially for this guy. All jokes apart, now we are going to our guide that from the hotel where we had booked our sand dunes, and he will be accompanying to this journey, roughly around 40 to 50 kilometers, and in between he may able to get us see some villages. So let's go.
Bye.
Bye, and have a nice day.